Can't make this stuff up. Joe has found a homeless camp. John is trying to get us out of here. Okay, we're back again to the same site. We went and got John. We got a looking at another angle at this top of the northwest mound and the curve, the trail we were showing from the outer side from the railroad track. We're getting ready to walk in there. Let's go in there. Let's go check it out, guys. We're on the other side of the mound. This is where they're working on President Street. We're just on the other side of the railroad track where we have been walking that trail right over there.
Anyway, I saw the one that guy put up with the Maya in the creek, the little effigy. And then on another one of his articles, he pointed out, and on his blog, he pointed out that the Cherokee for their museum in Dahlonega had delineated the Maya and Creek sun goddess as their symbol, and he posted a picture of that. And so me and Richard came out here looking for the Bilbo Mound, and the way he had it labeled was he had it labeled on the other side of that.
Of that overpass.
Yeah, he had it labeled on the other side of the overpass. And so I looked, and he had basically gotten a picture of the Google Earth and put where it was. I started looking at maps of Savannah, and I started seeing that on the old maps, where they have it designated, this quadrant is on both sides of this, because what he's seeing looking at the map now and then is this railroad. There was a road running down there, or still is, but it was running right there, and it looks like, if at first glance, if you look at my maps of Savannah, it looks like the Truman Pass is where that road used to be. So he's looking at it as if that's Truman Park, the railroad is you know what I mean, when he posted on
Truman
his blog.
Parkway.
So what I did is I was looking at it, and I couldn't see anything because of all the trees here, you know what I mean? I couldn't see what's going on in here on Google Earth. And so I finally, just out of the corner of my eye, looked down, and there's a new thing, way back thing on Google Earth. And I hit 1994, it turned into black and white, and it popped out on me, and Truman Parkway moved over to here. You know what I mean? The whole map was good, but Truman Parkway wasn't there. And so this thing moved, and it looked like, shoo! And right there, staring at me, was that effigy. You know what I mean? I'm like, and it's exactly, because I had it on the exact coordinates of Bilbo Mound, switched to 1994.
Which would be so, shape, could be a snake mound.
It could be, yeah.
It looked like it could be like this.
Mm-hmm. But see, I thought it was going to be it's hard
to tell, but.
Well, see, I thought it was going to be a rounded upward mound, and the way it looked, it's not. It's like a snake mound, and all the inside is filled with water.
Like a horseshoe
mound. Yeah.
But it has the
horseshoe here halfway
through the
road. Well, when we get back there, you can see some interesting stuff. Now, it looks like the city, a long time ago, started pumping sewage back in there and filling it. There's even a drainage tunnel right through that wall right there going into it. Okay, now the guy went to go see him, and he talked about the two,
we need to get appropriate footwear.
Yeah, no, I don't have any. We can't go very far because of that.
Need to
borrow a John boat from somebody.
They're digging right down here, right beside it.
This thing has kept running.
Let's take a look down in here.
Oh, yeah.
Here we are at the top of the rain mound.
See, right there you can see them back there.
Here's the first rain. Come on, John, we're going to show you more. Oops. Would have helped to walk with a flat foot.
Over here, where there's been a pipe drilled through here to there, but it looks...
It's old.
It's made out of stubble. Like
old concrete from way long ago.
Check it out. You see it on this side too. I guess that's all they did was
they ditched it along here to drain it.
Now this is colonial, like some kind of tabby season.
It might have been done in the early 1800s. Okay. We're thinking the area could have been mined later in the 1800s for some kind of mineral phosphate. So we do have kaolin here in the upper mid-state. So we got some kind of materials here too. But look at this shell ring, it's obvious. You can see it, we're filming. We're on this trail that probably is thousands of years old. We're gonna show you something pretty cool. You see a break in the land, delineation. We got water here. We got water up here. We got a long run down into the mound area there. We're gonna have to get a boat. Land is picking back up over here on the left side. We're gonna show John something that we found. I'm getting ready to cut it off so I can show you something in a second. Piece of ground across the creek over there.
When I try to get it on my computer, it puts me underground past this point. But it might be different on an iPhone, or you know, his iPhone looks better than my computer does.
There's the pipes Joe was talking about. They're scattered out through here. Look at this dabble of land right here at the end of the mound. This is very north. Is this western tip?
Now Richard, if you could
go ahead, I'm listening.
Oh yeah, we found a whole tent city back there. Right there above, if you look up above the mound, you can see what might be the top of her torch, because there's another mound beyond it, but it doesn't follow the curve that these two mounds follow. It kind of is jutting forward, kind of in a line with this little outcrop here. Okay. So that might be the top of the effigy right there. It raises beyond that a little more.
Okay, we got questions. We got to get over there. We got more questions.
I think it's like a temple, because what he was saying is they would dance in a ring around it until they got to the middle, and then that would bring rain.
Okay, we got questions, right, Joe?
Yeah, man.
The guy's missing. Calling doors.
Archaeologists
were hunting for some Indian mounds that are right here. We're archaeologists.
Archaeologists checking out the Indian mound.
There's an Indian mound right here, and we're just checking it out, man. Say again. There's a 4,000-year-old Indian mound in here. We're trying to find it. It's right here on this.
Is there a trail deeper back into the woods up here?
No.
All right, Richard.
All right.
Let's go.
Mia. Come on, Mia.
You know about any Indian mounds around
Richard.
Here?
There's none. No.
Thank you, sir. Mia. We're back at this mound at Scott Middle School. An obvious Indian mound.
Look at that. They can embed YouTube videos till you're blue in the face.
Look how big it is.
And set up a YouTube channel.
There's various paths leading down from each direction.
My idea for like the mine.
I think there's 1, 2, 3. With Joe and I counted 7 paths going to the bottom of this mound.
Anybody comes to Savannah, you know, we'll take them on a a walking tour of the city and a mound tour. Or whatever they want to do. You know, if they don't want to go trudging around the woods, just give them the one to the one.
Odd structure right over here. Then the mound. Looks like a step.
So there's this thing here for. They've put some over here for some reason. We don't know why.
Well, we got any questions, guys?
Well,
how old is this?
What do you think about this site? We don't know. There's no nothing cataloged about this. What do you think about this? We're thinking is it's built up. It could be a crescent moon shape.
It might be good to learn how to survey these sites and map them for our own purposes. Mm-hmm. And then what we do is get dimensions of the site, find out all historical and archaeological information on the site. And then from there, you can maybe use some sort of metal detections, ground penetrating radar, whatever the hell there is.
Just on the other side is the Hillcrest Abbey Catholic Cemetery. Gonna film some of this real quick because it's kind of interesting. Over there, see graves, tombs. There's miles and miles. All across the city of Savannah, we are a cemetery. This is the Catholic cemetery from the back side, where the little theater used to be. You can hear the birds chirping, and it's time to go home. It's about 6:30. It's getting dark.
I'll put together a reading pack for you all if you want.
Awesome.
I'll try to find the basic shit. I'll do a little bit of legwork. I have
very huge mound.
There's a lot of stuff on the torrent side.
Let's see how old that tree is. Okay, we're three. We got questions.